What's up, YouTube? It's Jane once again, and so watching SmackDown. It's 3:46 a.m. The show that came on, I went to sleep, so I didn't get to watch it. But I started watching it like an hour ago. But yeah, pretty much. But yeah, no, like I started watching like 1 a.m. or some shit, 1 or 2 a.m. some shit. I don't remember. But yeah, this show so far, I haven't seen the entire show yet, but for what I've seen the first segment with Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens, Matt Riddle, The Usos, and Solo Sikoa. Pretty much just the same exact segment we saw last week, and every week before that, it's going the exact same way. That segment, that was boring. Yeah, come on. After that, we had a match between LA Knight versus Xavier Woods. Like, LA Knight should have won that match. There's no reason why LA Knight's... Like, he comes back. It's not that he left, but we didn't see him on WrestleMania or any of those shows. And, like, the first match he has, you know, after WrestleMania, he loses. No reason he should be losing to fucking Xavier Woods. Like, come on, dude. Like, Xavier Woods should not be beating LA Knight in a fucking match, dude. That should not be happening. And he beat LA Knight twice in a match via a roll-up, I think. I think the first match he beat him with a roll-up. Yeah, he did. Is it fucking LA Knight twice via a fucking roll-up, dude? Come on. Like, that is pathetic. Third match, I'm trying to remember, this was Damian Priest versus Santos Escobar. Pretty good match. it was a pretty good match. You know, LWO was out there. They attacked the Judgment Day and stuff. Finn Balor wasn't there for whatever reason, but... Yeah, Finn Balor wasn't there, but... You know, LWO, all the LWO, Rey Mysterio and all them motherfuckers. And Damian Priest, Dominic Mysterio, and Rhea Ripley were there for the Judgment Day, but Finn Balor wasn't there for some reason, but yeah. Pretty decent match. I'm trying to think. This just must have happened in hour number one. Besides, like, those two matches being decently long. Then we had the segment between the Usos, Solo Sikoa, and Paul Heyman. He was talking Paul Heyman was bringing up a lot of the old fucking NOI family members. Like, oh, Yokozuna. Rikishi and all them, Haku and all them motherfuckers. That was pretty good segment. Then Solo spoke, he was like, tell the tribal chief, I got it, you know. That's the last thing I saw, so. I was trying to think if, no, that's not the last thing I saw. After that, I saw there's also a segment between Matt Riddle, Sami Zayn, and Kevin Owens backstage. I don't remember what they were talking about. I didn't care, to be honest. Let me tell you a lot of people don't care about Matt Riddle. I don't care about Matt Riddle, personally. But... Like, when he came back and he was attacking the bloodline and stuff, I was literally sitting there like, why is he attacking? Like, what is going on here? I literally forgot, like, what happened. And I'm literally watching the show. I was like, man, y'all better show, like, a segment or something. Like, to fucking show why he's attacking the bloodline. Because I don't even fucking remember what happened. And then they literally had to go show a segment. Because I know there's a lot of people who are sitting there like, man, why is Matt Riddle in this segment now? Because they definitely forgot, like, what happened between that and the bloodline. Because I literally forgot that happened. I know a lot of other people forgot that happened. But the very last thing I saw was the Women's Tag Team Champions coming out. Raquel Rodriguez and Liv Morgan are coming out to the ring. And then, you know, after that, I just want to go drop a deuce. I'm not going to lie to you. And now we're going to see where the show is going now. I'm going to go back to see if I miss anything. So after I watch the show, of course, I'm going to go back to see if I miss anything that I didn't talk about in this video. But, yeah, we'll be right back. Yeah, so I didn't talk about the Xavier Woods challenging Gunther for the Intercontinental Championship. I didn't even forget that when I was recording the first half. I was literally thinking that when I was talking about the Xavier Woods versus LA Knight match. I was thinking it, but I just didn't say it because, like, I don't care, man. Like, I like Gunther. I love Gunther. That's my boy. But, like, fucking Xavier Woods should not be challenging for the fucking Intercontinental Championship. That should be LA Knight in that match. That should have been Gunther versus LA Knight. I still don't want Gunther to lose his title, right? But still, that should be Gunther versus LA Knight. Not Gunther versus fucking Xavier Woods. Xavier Woods not beating LA Knight, bro. Come on, dude. Like, let's be for real here. He's not beating LA. Xavier Woods shouldn't have even beaten LA Knight to begin with, but he's not beating Gunther for the title. That's just not happening, bro. So, Gunther needs to keep his title. There is another segment I'm thinking of right now. I'm blanking. I literally just went back to see it. I'm blanking on it right now. Oh, yeah. Well, no, it's the same segment, but we're going through them. He was talking to Ludwig Kaiser and Giovanni Da Vinci. He was talking to them, and I don't even know German, I don't, Austria, I don't know what language they're speaking, but they're talking. That, like I said, Xavier Woods just comes up and challenging, like, that's like Xavier Woods challenging Gunther for the Intercontinental Championship. He shouldn't even be in a singles fucking, come on, dude, it's Xavier Woods. Like, he should not be going against, now, Xavier Woods is a good wrestler, but he should not be going for the Intercontinental Championship. But, like, and then they also showed us thing that Shinsuke's coming back, but, yeah, LA Knight should win the match. There's just no reason why Xavier Woods should be beating fucking, there's no reason why fucking Xavier Woods should be beating LA Knight. That just doesn't even make any sense. But, yeah, we'll be right back. Another thing. I was thinking this, but I couldn't remember what I was thinking, but, yeah, Damian Priest went against Santos Escobar. He won the match, and then, they literally won the match, and then they ran away at the end like they lost the match. So that's what WWE keeps doing right now. They're making people who win the match fucking run away like cowards. They keep doing this shit, making them look like little bitches after they won the fucking match. The amount of times this has happened in the past couple of weeks is getting ridiculous, man. Like, fucking 50-50 booking, man. It's fucking just atrocious, dude. It's garbage. Next was a fucking, I talked about Raquel Rodriguez and Liv Morgan coming out. They had a segment with fucking Chelsea Green and Sonya Deville. I skipped the segment. I'm not gonna lie to you. No, who gives a fuck, man? I don't care. Sonya Deville and Chelsea Green should not be getting fucking tag team title fucking opportunity in any fucking realm. Any realm of wrestling, dude. Like, come on, dude. No one gives a fuck. Like, they're just, like, they're basically jobbers at this point. They lose every fucking match. like, what are we doing, man? I completely skipped that segment. I don't give a fuck. Because they're giving these women's segments that I just don't care about, man. Give me the people I care about. Io Shirai, fucking Asuka, fucking Rhea Ripley. Some shit. Give them this fucking nonsense between. I just skipped that segment. Garbage. Don't care at all. Don't care. Alright, next we had a match between Shinsuke versus Madcap Moss. It was like a minute long match. Like, Madcap attacked him after the fucking, he tried to attack him after the match and he got put in an armbar. Madcap Moss literally lost like a minute, then he got put in an armbar right after. He was out there with Emma. Emma should just leave Madcap Moss or something. Emma's fucking hot, by the way. I've always liked Emma. She's hot. She needs to be leaving Madcap Moss and get back in the ring. That's what she needs to be doing. Madcap Moss is a goddamn clown. I mean, to be fair, if Emma's in the ring, she'll be losing too. They're both jobbers. But Madcap Moss is a goddamn jobber. Like, no one gives a fuck about Madcap Moss, dude. Come on. But since his outfit, his pants look nice, but this little top shit he has with, like, and it's like open here into like the chest area. That looks fucking terrible. The top part looks awful. The pants look cool. The top part just looks fucking stupid. He needs to take that top part off. That looks dumb. Keep the pants. But yeah, that was like a minute long match. That, like, come on. Madcap Moss is a goddamn clown. It's a fucking jobber. And then after Shinsuke beat Madcap Moss, we see Scarlett on the screen. She's so fucking hot. Oh, those fucking titties, man. They're so, her, them tits are huge, man. She's so hot. Gosh, she's hot, bro. Like, but she bit this card, right? We see her doing this on the fucking table. And then she picked up this card, bites the card, and lays it down. It was you see the back of the card when she bit the card. But then you see the front of the card, and it was Shinsuke. And then, Karrion Kross hit the table and said, "Tick tock." So, Karrion Kross versus Shinsuke Nakamura. It's going to be a good match, obviously. But Karrion Kross going for Shinsuke Nakamura. It's going to be good. And then right after that, we see Matt Riddle backstage getting ready for his match. Yeah. Karrion Kross versus Matt versus Shinsuke Nakamura is going to be good. Matt Riddle versus Solo should be a good match. But I don't care about Matt Riddle still. But, you know, hey. Scarlett's hot. And Emma's hot. So, yeah. But, yeah. Matt Riddle, Solo's a cool match about to start. And Paul Heyman was talking to Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens, saying that they will have a rematch against the Usos, and the Usos gonna win. And then Paul Heyman said, Tribal Chief is getting, what do you say? He's tired of waiting with you, or something like that. He's running out of patience with you two. That's what he said. But he was pointing at Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens. He says he's running out of patience with you two. But he was looking at Jay and Jimmy Uso. He's pointing at Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens, but looking at Jay and Jimmy Uso. So he said, he's running out of patience with you two. But he's pointing at the Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens, but looking at the Usos. I'm thinking, he's running out of patience with the Usos in there. And then, you know, obviously the bloodline's going to break down and shit like that. And then, funny thing, after that happened, They show some little match cards and stuff for next week. We're gonna see it showed the Usos versus Sami Zayn Solo Cole for the tag team championship in the main event, something like that. And people in the crowd were like, yeah. It showed Gunther versus David Rose for the Intercontinental Championship. Now there's a lot less noise, but you still heard, yeah, right? Then you get to the women's tag team championship match. It showed Raquel Rodriguez and Liv Morgan versus Sonya Deville and Chelsea Green, and the crowd was like this. Not a single sound was made. Not a single sound was made. That was so quiet. That was pathetic. That was just wow. That was just pathetic, man. And after that, it showed Ricochet and Braun Strowman versus the Viking Raiders. Then the crowd will back up. Yeah! Right? But that women's tag team match, the whole crowd just... They did not care, bro. I didn't care. I was sitting there quiet. The whole crowd was quiet. That was just pathetic. They do not care about them. That's the worst reaction that Omos gets. Yeah. I won't say as bad as Mia Yim, though. Mia Ching came out last week. Or not last week, on Raw this week. And the crowd literally made no sound whatsoever. It's worse than Omos' reaction. Omos has fucking at least no noise whatsoever. But they're like... You might hear like a little cough or something. You might hear a little something. Me and Yim came out fucking Raw, and the crowd was just the whole crowd just staring at her. Did not care. She knocks somebody down. She tried to hype up the crowd. She's like, okay. She did that like 3 times. The crowd did not react at all. I should have mentioned that in my video on Raw the other day. She knocked down Piper Niven or Io Shirai. She's like, okay. Crowd just sitting there, just dead silent, just like this. Went to the top rope. Okay, the crowd. She dived out the ring. Okay, the crowd. No one cared at all about her, man. That is like one of the worst reactions I've ever seen. It's not as bad. The worst reaction of all time has got to be that Sky Too Hottie, Brian Christopher reaction when he came back for that Michael Cole and Jerry Lawler storyline back in like 2011 or something. That, man, that reaction was just literally silent. There was no sound. That was actually worse than mediums. That's worse than Omos. Like, silent. No noise at all. You could literally hear... You could just hear a pin drop or something. Like, it was awful. You could probably hear somebody's heartbeat. That's how quiet that shit was. But pathetic. No one even knew who he was. But yeah, that woman's match, no one cares. Just silent, man. But right now, we're going to Matt Riddle and Solo Sikoa. We're going to see what's going on here. Also, before I watch this match, I can already foresee what's going to happen. There's like 11 minutes left in the show or something. Let me check. See how much time's left. I just saw this a little bit ago. Okay, we got literally 10 minutes left in the show. 10 minutes and 13 seconds left in the show. Either Solo Sikoa is winning the match. He's not losing to Matt Riddle. Come on now. So either Solo Sikoa is winning the match and they have a brawl, or the match is going to just break down and they're going to have a brawl out here. Like, right now. Like, either way, just some shenanigans is going to happen right now. We got 10 minutes and 13 seconds left. Come on. 10 minute match. Some shenanigans are going to happen. Like, just you wait. Like, literally, on my screen, all you can see is Matt Riddle and Solo Sikoa and the Usos over there, and the Usos over there, and Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens over there. They're literally just standing there. So, shenanigans are going to happen, dude. Shenanigans, obviously. Just watch the match between Solo Sikoa and Matt Riddle. Yeah, literally, like what I just told you, I literally said Solo Sikoa is going to win the match, and I said it's going to be a brawl outside. I literally said that. That's exactly what happened. Come on, it's the bloodline segments. Come on, it's getting redundant at this point. It's starting to happen over and over. So we knew what's gonna happen. We knew Solo Sikoa was gonna win that match, and Solo won that match, and he beat Matt Riddle, and then the Usos had a brawl. So that was Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens. That's like what happened. They got ejected at first, right? Then the Usos, Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens got ejected. Jey Uso. Jimmy Uso also got ejected. The crowd fucking like, yeah, when they got ejected. And then Jay and Jimmy end up coming back to the crowd. And then Kevin and Sammy at the same time. Cammy. I'm going to start calling them Cammy Zowens. Cammy Zowens right there. Kevin and Sammy. Cammy Zowens. Fucking. I'm saving that. I'm calling them Cammy Zowens from now on. Cammy Zowens, man. They came back out. And then, when they came out, they ended up having a brawl with the Usos. right? And then, you know, Matt Riddle dived out onto the Usos, and then, you know, Matt Riddle over to the top, tried to dive on Solo Sikoa. Solo Sikoa super kicked him right to his stomach, and then he picked him up, some more spike, 1, 2, 3, goes outside. Uranagi's him right on top of the table. He takes the little announce table crap off, and then he puts the announce table onto Matt Riddle. Pretty decent match, of course. Like, it's two good wrestlers in the match, so that's what you expect. I want to bring this up too because I just found this funny. I saw this like a month ago. I just laughed because it was funny. Logan Paul said, he said anybody in the back wants to talk shit, beat the fuck out of him. I just laughed so hard because I was like, bro, you're not gonna go up to fucking Brock Lesnar and say that, bro. You're not gonna go to, because Brock Lesnar is a former UFC champion. You're not gonna go to Bobby Lashley. He was also a UFC champion, right? I'm not gonna go to Matt Riddle, who's also in the UFC. So like, me and UFC people, I'm not sure if Matt Riddle won a title in UFC, but or some shit, or MMA, whatever the fuck. But these are all UFC guys. So you're not gonna beat any of them, bro. I just thought that was funny, but I just brought it up because Matt Riddle. But yeah, that segment was predictable. Like, I literally called it before it happened. Well, it happened, but I called it before I saw it. But man, yeah, a predictable seven, and yeah, pretty okay show. Nothing great, honestly. Kind of predictable. Entire show, the entire women's segment, no one gave a fuck. I didn't give a fuck. Did you care? No, you didn't. Yeah, decent, not even decent. Like, pretty mid show, to be honest. But you know, it is what it is. But yeah, it's been Shane once again. I'm out. Peace.